Okay, so this is a short video that's going to show you how to use the Easy YouTube Caption Creator to create captions for your YouTube videos. We have a video, it's a short interview with my daughter, and you'll hear it play back in a second. I'm going to take the URL of the video, copy it to the clipboard, and paste it into the YouTube address line in Easy YouTube Caption Creator. Click Next. I've prepared a transcript of that video. It's a very short video, only 58 seconds long. And I've put each chunk of transcript on a single line. So each bit of transcript that I want to appear on one screen in my pop-on captions in my video, I've put on each line in the transcript. So I'm going to take the transcript, copy it to the clipboard, paste it into this text area in step two of the Easy YouTube Caption Creator, and click the split button. And it takes those lines and it splits them into separate lines here. You can see them all down here. And it gives me the video to play back. So I'm going to go ahead and click play to play the video. And each time I hear the caption spoken, I'm going to click the A key, and that will assign a timestamp to that particular caption chunk. Here it goes. We hope. Okay, so that's gone through the video and it's put timestamps next to each bit. I'm going to go ahead and copy out these timestamps and paste them into a file that's got an extension of .sub. This is eva.sub. And I want to take a look at these here just to show you what they look like. So the way the subviewer format looks is it's got hours, minutes, seconds, and hundredths of a second, and then the caption chunk below it. And it has to have that format exactly, or it just won't work. Now, for some reason, some of these have gotten slightly mucked up, and so I'm going to go back in here and change some of them. Looks like there's a bug in Accessify. That's all right. But you're going to want to look through just to double check. I've noticed here, like, all of a sudden when it gets to 32 seconds, it thinks it's a minute and 32 seconds, when in fact it's just 32 seconds. So I'm going to need to change those back to zeros. The other thing I'm doing here, as I'm working my way through this, is I'm breaking each of these caption chunks into lines, individual lines that make them more readable. So it's a dialogue between me and my daughter, and when I say something and she says something, I want each of those things to start on a separate line. Now, if I were to upload this in exactly this format to YouTube, for the subviewer format, will string all of these captions onto one line, even if I've broken them onto multiple lines, and I don't like that. So I'm going to change the format of this from subviewer to subrip, and we've written a little script that will do the conversion for you. So now that file looks pretty good. I don't see any errors in the timestamps. The program that we've written, it's a very short little program. It's called subviewer-to-subrip.exe. And it takes minus minus file, and you after the file you put in the your file your caption file, which is eva.sub in this case, and then dash dash vid length, and that's the total length of the video. It's 58 seconds long, And it needs to go in exactly this format. And if you don't put it in this format, the program will warn you. When I hit enter, it will say subrip file eva.srt created. Let's go ahead and take a look at eva.srt. Here it is. And it looks pretty good. The conversion's gone fine. I don't see any errors in here. Now, so I'm going to go ahead and take this file. I'm going to upload it to YouTube. Go back to your YouTube page and log on to your account. Go to My Videos, find the video that you want to associate that caption file with, and click the Edit button. On the next screen, click on Captions and Subtitles. And then click on Browse to browse for that file. It's eva.srt that I want to upload. I need to give it a language. I'm going to give it English. And then I click Upload. And it goes ahead and it makes the association. Now, it'll start to play back. And right now, you're not seeing the captions appear. It takes a little while for YouTube to catch up. But trust me, they will appear. We'll pause the video here for a minute and we'll wait. And we'll show them appearing. So I'm going to go ahead and go back to the video homepage. Then I'm going to load the video into YouTube. See if they've appeared yet. Still not there. We'll pause for a second and let them catch up. Okay, after about 3 minutes, YouTube recognized that there were captions there and made the association between the video and the caption, and this is what they look like. So there they are. Pop on captions with the proper line breaks in them, like we wanted. You can find out more about this process and get our subviewer to sub rip script at wac.osu.edu/examples/youtube-player-controls. Thanks.